Every great Steven Universe episode is memorable for a different reason. Some have a fantastically catchy song that adds to the episode's theme. Others may have terrific visuals unlike anything else in the series, or some really well-written dialogue that expands the characters we know and love. Some episodes, though, like the one we're talking about today, do all of this and more. In this video, we're going to go through the season 4 episode Mindful Education and talk about how it uses everything great about the series to fit an entire phenomenal discussion about moving forward in only 11 minutes.
And this side is for Stevani. It's two signs in one, a fusion sign.
The episode starts off with Connie coming to the temple to train, but it's clear from the beginning that she has something else on her mind. I love how goofy the bald cap Steven is, and it's a great in-character way for him to realize that Connie really is operating at minimal function while her brain thinks about something entirely separate. Steven catches on pretty quickly, but his question to Connie about whether or not she's okay is interrupted by the arrival of Pearl, who announces that Garnet will be sitting in on today's training, as today the pair are training as Stevani. Connie's uncharacteristically unnerved and unexcited about this news as she attempts to appear happy for everybody else. We quickly move to the actual training session, which is filled with nice touches, including the fact that Pearl prepared a fusion version of Hollow Pearl to match Stevani as their opponent. The fusion dances on both sides are sonically and visually terrific as always, and while it is a pretty short scene, it pretty much has to with the episode's length, the fight with Fusion Hollow Pearl has some really well done choreography showing Stevani at temporary full strength, and I especially love the Yoshi-esque flutter jump that they discover during this fight. But as it comes to a close, the background quickly shifts into this geometric orange space that we'll become more acquainted with later, as the Hollow Pearl fusion shifts into a very un-Steven Universe young boy. This vision shakes up Stevani as they break apart, and the fantastic voice direction to have Stevani shift into a more Connie-like voice makes it clear who this image is coming from. She runs away from a concerned Steven, Pearl, and Garnet, and when Steven eventually catches up to her, Connie finally reveals the culprit for her scattered mind.
I did something terrible at school, and I don't know what to do. I beat someone up.
It's a very non-Connie line that kind of shakes the episode and Steven up. If you're able to get past the shock value of this line, as well as the funny image of Connie beating up a middle schooler, you'll catch Steven giving some pretty terrible advice in response to this.
Sometimes you hurt people by accident, you just have to try not to think about it.
This line makes a couple of things obvious that will play out throughout the rest of the episode, being that Steven relates to Connie's story of hurting others by accident, and that he's going to ultimately be the one learning the lesson at the end of this thing. Before Connie has a chance to respond to Steven, Garnet interrupts and takes us to the beach, where she drops some vague knowledge to Steven and Connie, and eventually to Stevani. She re-explains some stuff that we already know, being that a fusion is broken apart if either member is mentally unstable, clearly putting even further pressure on Connie that she's messing things up for everybody. Garnet has Stevani close their eyes as she takes us into the most iconic scene in the episode, and one of the greatest songs in Steven Universe. The song is over 3 minutes long, therefore taking up over a fourth of the episode, so we're gonna be on it for a good chunk of time. The scene immediately drops us into a blue version of the geometric background from before, although this time with seemingly softer curves, inducing a much calmer atmosphere. The background of the scene is only one part of what becomes its pretty unique identity, as the animation, done by the terrific Studio Trigger, slows down its frame rate to match the unique groove of the song, and to become stylistically more rigid to match one of the most lyrically clunky songs in the show. And that isn't a criticism of the song in the slightest, as the wordy lyrics and the slant rhymes like Charming and Swarming add to the general vibe of the scene to create something entirely new for the show. The Ruby and Sapphire stuff is up first, and it has some really fun and some really beautiful shots, and it's always fun to see the pair. The butterfly motif is introduced here, and is a really interesting take on the whole butterflies in the stomach thing. I love how both gems are overwhelmed by the butterflies in different ways, as Sapphire is overtaken by an overpowering storm, while Ruby hyperfixates on a single one, and is only able to help Sapphire once she gets over her own troubles. The feeling of true isolation in both characters is shown really really well with some fantastic staging, and the music builds up sonically and thematically as the animation does. The second half of the song, sung by Stevani, takes a less metaphorical approach and actually shows us what happened at Connie's school through some fantastically clever sequences using the butterflies. Besides Connie's definition of beating up being a bit off, the attention to detail in such a tiny scene that doesn't even fill up the screen is really impressive, as Connie's eyes show that everything that she did was just reflexive. Fully completing the butterfly metaphor, at least for now, is Connie fully confronting her memory of her moment of guilt, and only then being able to finally let it go. I love how the song finishes with all four non-fusions sharing a castle in the sky moment, as the characters coming together is what ultimately gets rid of their intrusive thoughts. Overall, this song and the accompanying animation is genuinely terrific throughout. So many great sequences fit into about 3 minutes, as the song takes over the episode in a way that's not seen anywhere else in the series. Anyway, after the song, the episode cuts back to the temple as we get to the final part. It turns out that in a very Connie way, she followed exactly what Garnet was trying to tell her and talked to the kid that she beat up. While obviously meant to be unintentional within the show, the way that Connie talks about her conflict resolution to Steven comes off as if she's almost rubbing it in Steven's face, as he realizes that he won't be able to get such a nice resolution to his issues, or he's harmed others out of what he deemed to be necessity at the time. Steven goes out to train, but notices the same symbolic butterfly on his mother's sword, as he realizes what's coming. And very quickly into the second training sequence, that's exactly what happens, as Stevani is transported back into the same orange background as before, as Hollow Pearl transforms into Bismuth to recreate her poofing, making what is probably my favorite frame of the episode. The music of the scene is just impeccable in creating a horrific atmosphere, as Steven realizes what is happening, and Connie is completely hopeless in just watching Steven's worst nightmare. After a brief moment where the fusion pops out of it, they sink right back in, this time backing into Jasper, whose already horrifying corrupted design is taken to another level. Eventually, she transforms into Eyeball to complete the trio of gems that Steven has had to harm and feels pretty immense guilt about. Connie tries to calm Steven down here, but it only makes it worse, as we get a claustrophobic spinning scene in a three. This scene really captures the feeling of being trapped that's done with Sapphire back in the song, as Stevani appears completely hopeless. As the trio begins to combine into one form, Stevani trembles in fear of what it could possibly be, completely terrified of what could possibly be worse than what they're already seeing. Eventually, the butterflies take form, becoming a disappointed Rose Quartz, literally looking down on the fusion and on Steven. He's confronted with the idea once again that Rose gave up her life for him and that all he has done with it is hurt people. This thought just completely breaks Steven and thus Stevani, as they are metaphorically and literally pushed off the edge, as a horrified Pearl and Garnet hopelessly watch all of this unfold. The entire sequence is just terrific and definitely showcases some of the introspection that the show will dive much deeper into by the time that future rolls around. Anyway, back to the episode, the last scene is this beautifully animated freefall where Connie has to calm down a completely broken Steven. It feels like a complete role reversal where Steven is the one receiving the very Steven help instead of the other way around. Connie's words to Steven clearly echo that of Garnet earlier in the episode, as he receives the opposite of the advice that he gave Connie back at the training ground. Instead of pushing the thoughts of your past guilt away while it continues to build up, you have to think about it, even if it doesn't result in you moving completely past it like it did with Connie. Steven eventually agrees, although notably not very full-heartedly, as Stevani dives back into the now familiar geometric hellscape from before, this time confronting the symbolic thoughts as directly as possible. And instead of showing them defeating these thoughts or getting rid of them, the episode just cuts to Stevani barely making it safe and reassuring themselves that they're gonna be okay.
I'm here.
This episode has always been one of my favorites from the show, and there's not a specific reason for it. Besides just feeling both simultaneously shorter than 11 minutes and still fitting in a ridiculous amount of stuff into the quarter hour, this episode just excels at everything it goes for. But as much as I can talk about the fantastic song or the ridiculously impressive visuals throughout the entire thing, every part of this episode is ultimately geared towards its theme of being able to move past intrusive thoughts of what one regrets from their past, which is is something that resonates throughout the entire series. While later episodes like Storm in the Room, as well as a good chunk of Future, address this idea more full on, it's really interesting to see the show address the traumatic effect that all of the events of the show must have had on Steven, especially as it seems like he's sometimes portrayed as immune to the conflict as he focuses on others. While Steven is the son of Rose Quartz and the eventual savior of the gem and human worlds, he's also just a 14-year-old kid, and no episode presents that juxtaposition quite as well as Mindful Education. Anyway, that's pretty much gonna be it for me. So if you have any idea or show or character or concept or literally anything you want to see me cover from a cartoon, let me know in the comments or come and hunt me down on Twitter if it still exists when this video comes out. Either way, this has been April Samuel, and I'll see you in some unit of time with another video that's hopefully actually less pretentious this time. Thanks for watching.